Under the tree.
This many people at one floor, under one slab.
Okay, fine.
Back to that story. Okay, in a village, what happens is like a mom, you know, very close to his son. Okay, she can't live without his son. Okay, but son is like kind of a, you know, very young, energetic, like you guys. He want to explore more things, you know. But he want to sell his boots and all to that other village. Okay. During that time, mother had to leave that son for a week or a month time. So, he said to his son so many times, don't go, you know, whatever you are making, make here only. Don't go outside the village. But, obviously, son won't understand because he is in that pure age, right? So, he can't understand, he wants to leave. So, during that time, what his mother said, like, while going to other village, whenever you want to take rest, you have to sit under the tamarind tree, okay? Tamarind tree, yes, under the tamarind tree. Whenever you are coming back, you have to sit under the mango tree, okay? They are the reason for you. Next. So, after a few steps or a few kilometers, he was like tired and he want to sit. So, he find that tamarind tree, he sat under the tamarind tree. So you know that characteristics of tamarind tree, it generates more heat and you know, you feel uncomfortable. You can't sit there for more hours. So he started feeling, you know, feverish, he's not able to find, you know, that comfortable to reach to that village. So what happened is like, he started to come back to that village, okay? The very next day.
Yes.
So he started sitting under that mango tree, he started feeling comfortable. And slowly that whatever goods he got like sold out, okay? And then next one. And then he reached home as early as possible, and reached, okay? So mother was like very happy. Mother is like too smart, you know. She knows the characteristics of tree and, you know, importance of the tree and all. So and then he started realizing like, I can sell the goods over here also. Why should I go there, okay? So, next one. This story was sent to me, my grandmother. When I was in Delhi, this story was sent to me, my grandmother said, your mother is also looking for you, so come soon. Okay? That's why I ended up here. Okay? It's also good. Somewhere, you know, we detached from that nature, you know, till our grandparents, you know, attached to that nature, and even still, my grandmother used to tell each and every piece of characters, you know, medicinal values and other values also, but our parents, you know, I'm not blaming our parents, but our parents, you know, somewhat missed that, okay, but now what happened to that current contemporary architecture, sustainable architecture, what we are doing it? We are doing tree for aesthetic purpose. Okay? We are not sitting under the tree. We are putting trees for parking cars. Okay? Next. Yeah. For we want a beautiful view from that inside the house. So that we will keep that aesthetical ornamental trees only outside the house. So we want to sit inside from that house. We want to see that frame. We don't want to, you know, interact with the nature, right?
Next.
And then this is the worst thing, you know, bones are there, all you know. Previously we were under the trees, now like we were above the trees, okay? The trees are under us, okay? We are dominating.
That shouldn't be done. Next.
Yeah. That weird thing happening nowadays, you know, vertical farming, you know, terrace farming, trees are also kind of a space, you know. They have to grow in the ground only. They will take their own decision. They won't disturb you guys, okay? So they won't disturb you for like putting minerals or every day or water something. If you keep it at the land itself, it will grow automatically, okay? Next. Yes. If we are under the tree, we are relaxed, down close, you know. very enjoyed. If you are above the trees, you know, life becomes more complicated and more difficult. Okay? So, for me, vernacular means, you know, conserving trees or preserving trees or saving or respecting the trees. Okay? It's not only like, you know, preserving, conserving like 100 years, 500 years buildings. We have to conserve like 100 years, 200 years trees also. Okay? So, for me, it's like service to nature, and then service to neighbor, and then service to nation. Okay? And then respect to elders. Okay? They will tell you more things about it. And thank you so much.
Really amazing. God bless you. Thank you.